esquina. A gente tá. Pessoal da esquina, tudo bom? A gente está aqui no Mackenzie, diretamente do Seminário de Gestão Inovadora de Bairros Históricos. Aqui ao meu lado, o Alan Lipietz. Hello, Alan. Thank you for talking to us. Ele apresentou ontem a visão dele a respeito da reurbanização, da questão social. Então, como é que as pessoas, principalmente operários, né, foram sendo removidos de bairros, e especialmente em Paris, ele contou essa história da reurbanização de Paris, para outros lugares com os quais eles não tinham exatamente uma ligação. E aí ele questionou um pouco isso: será que todo o processo de reurbanização e requalificação do território tem a ver com você deslocar essas pessoas menos favorecidas? So Alan, yesterday you talked about Paris experience, yes, the reurbanizing of Paris. Could you please detail for us?
Yes, yesterday I focused on popular neighborhood. There is a form of popular neighborhood in Paris which is very famous. There is even movies about it. Renoir, Carnet, Prévert, Duvivier, and a school of cinema focusing on this kind of property. And well, it's a place where there are places like to live. Not very dangerous, because the economics of drugs is not much involved in this kind of quarters. A kind of way of living, very, very classical, I would say. And of course, there is a tendency to destroy this neighborhood, either for financial speculative reasons, because they are
real estate.
Yes, real estate. They are very well placed. So there is a demand for this site, not regarding its human quality. Another tendency is gentrification by bourgeois bohème. It's a much slower tendency, but it's also very dangerous.
Yeah.
That is, in a crawling way, more and more artists live in this neighborhood. But also, you know, workers of advertisements, teachers, etc., etc., because it is nice, that's all. And that it's living, and as a result, the price increases, and the popular population has to go away. So, the two ways of destroying these neighborhoods, at the end, it's the same. They are quite different, the process and the willingness is not the same, but it's a problem. So, if we try to protect them just by saying we buy some spots of the state, Paris city, could buy some spots, you have a kind of transformation into a museum, you know, just a museum. Like Amélie Poulain, quoted the movie Amélie Poulain, I think. Well, it was a great success in the world. So now there are buses of Japanese tourists coming to see the pub and the pub of Amélie Poulain, the shop, vegetable shop of Amélie Poulain. Quite ordinary one, in fact. There were a lot of these in Paris, say, 30 years ago. But the fact is that they are disappearing because of these two processes. Either destruction by real estate developments or holding out by the gentrification, by intellectual new creative places.
O Alan está explicando para a gente que os bairros em Paris têm uma situação específica, de um bairro que ele diz que não era um bairro perigoso de maneira nenhuma, era um bairro ok, mas que existe um interesse muito grande do mercado imobiliário em construir ali e aí retirar as pessoas que originalmente ocupavam aquela região. E também, de outro lado, existe a própria classe criativa ali de... A gente estava até falando anteriormente, né, as startups, arquitetos, designers que trabalham com o processo de criação, de utilizarem esses imóveis, e aí também isso acaba expulsando essa população, que é uma população com renda inferior, que não consegue arcar com os custos dos aluguéis conforme o preço desses imóveis sobe. You mentioned that the city of Paris could buy those places. It's a common practice?
Yes, it does it.
We have a problem in Brazil to maintain the public buildings.
Yes.
How do you do that in Paris?
It's a policy, a public policy. There was a coalition of socialists and green party who conquested the city of Paris 10 years ago, and they are developing it. But the problem is, since Paris is extremely demanding, of course you can maintain popular classes in Paris at the price of just buying flats and offering at a low rate these spaces. But of course, it's create a kind of aristocracy. How can we select the beneficiaries? For instance, if you create 2,000 social housing 1 year, to whom will you give it?
Who?
I don't know. Probably it can introduce a form of political clientelism.
But you have criteria.
We have criteria, of course.
Some transparency on criteria.
Yes, there are criteria, children, the revenue, of course. Basically, the revenue. It's only for poor people.
Mm-hmm.
And then, but the rest of the criteria, you don't know.
Ele está falando que em alguns locais a cidade de Paris acaba comprando os edifícios para garantir a manutenção. Isso é uma política que mudou especialmente de 10 anos para cá, principalmente pela mudança do governo da cidade, mas que também isso ele traz um questionamento dos critérios, por exemplo, quando a cidade oferece esses edifícios para habitação social. Então, claro que a gente tem aí critérios de renda, ele diz que tem que também a existência de crianças acaba sendo um critério definidor, mas que muitas vezes você mesmo assim cria aristocracias, ele usou esse termo, na ocupação desses imóveis, já que os espaços de Paris a gente sabe que são muito concorridos.
It is different from what we call historical buildings, quite former palaces, former hotel of a rich people of a 17th century, 18th century. But even in that case, the city of Poitiers, for instance, which has too much of this kind of buildings, use them as social housing too. I mean, you transform it, or you restore it for the beauty of the water, but inside you can also have social housing.
But it's not a government problem.
It is a local.
It's
a city of Poitiers.
It's a company that made...
The company of social housing of the city.
Okay, great. Ele está explicando que os projetos, muitas vezes, eles significam o restauro de edifícios que não são de uma importância histórica tão grande, embora sejam preservados, e o interior deles pode ser usado para habitação social também. You're saying about the Amélie Poulain-Tour. Do you think it's a founding, a source of founding for preservation, those kinds of tours?
It could have been, but it is not.
No. Ele tinha mencionado...
It's a good idea, but it is not.
Ele tinha mencionado que em Paris existe o tour da Amélie Poulain e outros tours que as pessoas fazem, eu estou questionando se isso não poderia ser uma forma de financiamento para a preservação desses locais. How do you think finance...
The problem is that the quality of the remaining social quarters, popular quarters, is such that there is a demand to live in. And either it's the creative classes who buy the flats, or even people buy the flats in order to hire to tourists.
So there's a fight,
yes. So there's a fight of a city, of Paris municipality, against B&B because of that. Because financially, Paris is transforming itself into a huge hotel.
Ele está falando que existe um embate da prefeitura de Paris com o Airbnb para que a cidade não fique vazia ali à espera de locações. E isso, essa reserva de mercado, né, vou usar esse termo bem entre aspas, não foi o que ele usou, mas essa reserva desses imóveis acaba elevando o preço geral da cidade. And how can we equalize that?
Well, for instance, I don't know how they do in the other city, because Barcelona has exactly the same problem, a lot of historical cities are exactly the same problem. They transform into the B&B big hotel.
Yes.
And well, the first solution is to restrict the right to buy your own flat as a full guy. This B&B restricted to, say, 60 days a year, which is normal because if you have it, this pad, it's normal that you are away 2 hours a year, on holidays, for instance, because I am. Why not? The problem is now it is transforming into informal contact to be fine. Now there is a tax between B&B, which is increasing, because it could finance also the restoration of Paris. I think my problem, the real solution is that the restriction of the popular liberal in Paris creates the concentration of demand in some rare pockets. I gave the example yesterday. Montmartre is typically to focus the huge demand, both for B&Bs and for artists or teachers. No, the real estate.
No.
It's controlled now. It's impossible to destroy a part of Montmartre and build a skyscraper like in San Paulo. This is impossible. But the risk is somebody buy, say, six flats and hire it as a B&B. And this is more or less controlled. The real problem is that a lot of people, my brother-in-law, my own daughter, they live in this Bobo land. my daughter is in 19th arrondissement, which is transforming more or less into this kind of concentration. My brother-in-law lives in Montmartre, etc. They are intellectual, creative, social classes, teacher. They just like it because it's living. And they like to go to the pub or the shop nearby and buy their bread, etc., etc. But as a result, they are calling out involuntarily the very people for which they have come in that place. And I think the only solution is to avoid the destruction of this kind of water, because elsewhere there is a concentration. If the shop of Amélie Poulain and the pub of Amélie Poulain are the two last ones in Paris, you imagine the freshness there is on it. If there are heaps of
all over
Paris, all the suburbs of Paris, because the Ivry is transforming exactly the same way. Nanterre is destroyed, but Ivry has possibility to save itself. So I think the protection of the neighborhood as a cultural asset, popular neighborhood, even if there is nothing from the 19th or 10th or 18th or 12th century, because it's a principal way to protect the historical character. No, just 20th, early 20th century, a neighborhood with popular class there, it should be protected as such.
Do you think companies like Airbnb should help to protect the heritage? Financing, I mean.
Yes, we are creating a tax on secondary residences, that is, residences, a flat where people do not live, so it is susceptible to be applied to B&B, but also to children, or sisters, or aunts. So it's a difficult way to manage.
To measure.
But the principal solution is exactly this one. Create more taxes on the flats which are not used as a principal one. This is a way of financing public services on the one. Because there is a real problem in Saint-Denis, I think. Saint-Denis, there are two islands, one in Paris.
Yeah.
One where is the cathedral and a very beautiful one where everybody got there. All the writers and sculpture, painters of Latin America possess this island. I understand they come every 2 months or a week, a year, or something like that. But when it is for B&B, it's a bit too much. And yeah, I would like to pay a lot just for this fact.
Ele falou sobre a possibilidade de taxar empresas como a Airbnb que utilizam esses imóveis e deixam esses imóveis fechados. Isso acaba contribuindo para a degradação. E ele diz que a solução de fato é aumentar o imposto, ainda que seja muito difícil você conseguir ter a medida exata, que você só está pegando os imóveis que estão para alocação e não onde tem gente morando e usando de fato. Alan, thank you very much for your time and your attention with us. Bye bye. Pessoal da esquina, obrigado. Até a próxima.